Good day to everyone. Let's see how a phase failure relay is wired to the electrical circuit of a three-phase motor. Phase failure relay will monitor the condition of the three incoming phases, and will cut off the control power input to the operating contactor, if any fault is found. These faults include loss of phase, phase sequence difference, undervoltage and overvoltage. Some phase failure relays provide monitoring of voltage asymmetry, with percentage difference adjustment facility, and also monitor neutral loss on a four-wire system. Let's do the wiring of this three-phase induction motor, including a phase failure relay. We need to include a three-pole breaker for three-phase motor, MCB, for control power circuit, and also a magnetic contactor with thermal overload intact. Now, install all these in a panel board. Here we have included start and stop push buttons, and indicator lamps to show motor run and motor off positions. Amber color indication lamp is provided, to indicate the overloading of the motor. PFR of course has its own indicating system with colored LED bulbs, but here on the panel board, we can include two indicator lamps to show whether the phases are in order or at fault. A buzzer too can be added to show any fault, but not included here. To show the wiring, let's take all the indicator lamps and the two push button switches out of the switchboard. PFR, magnetic contactor, and the two breakers too, are taken out here. First, wire the motor with three phase lines through the three-pole breaker and the contactor. Then, wire the phase failure relay L1, L2 and L3 terminals with red, yellow and blue sequence. Although I have shown the lines are tapped in the middle for easy reference here, it should be from the inlet ports on a magnetic contactor. Now take one phase line from PFR top, or even from contactor top is okay, and through the control circuit MCB, connect it to the common port of the PFR. This line will be the 230-volt control phase line, for the operation of the magnetic contactor coil, and for the operation of the 230-volt indicator lamps. When three-phase voltage is supplied to the phase failure relay, it will monitor the condition of the phases, and if everything is okay, normally open contact points on the common terminal will be closed. So we use this terminal to continue wiring work, and connect it to the terminal 95 of the thermal overload relay. Terminals 95 and 96 are the normally closed contact points of the thermal overload relay and will open if there is any overload condition of the motor. Control power line is taken through these points to protect the motor, and from terminal number 96, it connects to the start push button switch, through the normally closed stop push button switch. Other end of the normally open start push button is connected to the A1 coil end of the magnetic contactor. A2 coil end needs to be connected to the neutral line. If the start push button is pressed now, contactor operating coil will be energized, and the motor will start running. But the circuit will be broken, and the motor will be stopped, as soon as the push button is released back. Here we need an additional wiring for contactor holding circuit. So we take a line from left side of the start push button switch, and connect it to the bottom terminal of the normally open auxiliary contact points, on the contactor. From the top terminal of it, is connected to the A1. This additional circuit will continue to hold the contactor on its on position, when start push button is released. To break this holding on circuit, we need to press the stop push button once. To show that the motor is running, connect wire from A1 to the motor run indicator lamp. Add neutral line to the lamp. To show the motor is at stop position, we use normally closed auxiliary contact points on a magnetic contactor. First, connect the bottom terminal of the NO contact points to the bottom terminal of the NC contact points. Then connect the top terminal of the NC contact points to the motor off indicator lamp. Connect the neutral line to the lamp. To show the motor is tripped due to overload condition, We use the 97 and 98 normally open contact points on the thermal overload relay. If thermal overload is activated due to a fault of the motor, 97 and 98 will be closed. At the same time, 95 and 96 will be opened, hence terminal 96 does not get power. So connect terminal 95 to 97 first. Then connect terminal 98 to motor overload trip indicator lamp. Connect neutral line 2 to the lamp. For PFR position indication on switchboard, PFR normal indicator lamp is wired through the normally open contact points on the left side of the common terminal. PFR failure indicator lamp, we use normally closed contact points on the right side of the common terminal of the phase failure relay. When you switch on the three-pole breaker, PFR gets three-phase power, and if there isn't any fault on three lines, normally open contact point terminal on the left side of the common port will be closed. Now the PFR normal lamp and the motor off position lamp should light up. It didn't happen since the control power MCB is at off position yet. When you switch it on, indication works correctly. Now if you press this start push button, motor starts working. Also the motor run indicator lamp is on now. To stop the motor, press the stop push button. Motor stops and indication also shows motor is at off position. During motor running, if it overloads, the motor trip indicator lamp will show that it is due to overloading of the motor. Now the motor stop lamp is not indicating since power is out from the terminal 96 onwards. During motor operation, if one phase is lost, motor stops and the illuminated PFR fail indication is the only indication we get on the switchboard. So we can open the panel board and see the actual fault on three-phase line, since LED bulbs on the PFR will indicate it clearly. Hope you got fair knowledge now on how a PFR operates and how to install one onto a switchboard for a three-phase induction motor. If this video is helpful, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you.